Hello! Today we will be talking about slash reviewing, whatever you would like to call it, Insidious The Red Door. This is supposed to be the grand finale to the franchise. This is the fifth movie within it. The last one was The Last Key, but that was kind of a prequel to the first Insidious. And then this is a continuation from, I believe, the second Insidious, because they bring back the original family. The kid's much older now, and it's pretty much how the family's dealing with the trauma of the events of the first two films. And this will be a spoiler-filled review. So that's just your forewarning right now. So anyway, without further ado, shall we begin? So Insidious, The Red Door. Like I was saying, this is the conclusion of the Insidious franchise. I've watched the series pretty much on and off. I haven't seen any one of them in theaters, but I have seen 1, 2, 3, 4, and now 5. And I just did a review for The Last Key, which is the fourth one. If you're curious about that review, it should be up on the channel. And like I was saying, this is simply just going to be a review for The Red Door. And there will be spoilers sprinkled in throughout this video, so I just wanted to give that as a heads up first. But anyway, this plot follows the family, I believe, about 20 years later, I believe it says. But the son is much older now because he's going into college. And I gotta say, this movie didn't really have like a whole lot of jump scares. There was only two in this film, which actually made me go like that. But I really, really like the plot of this film. I liked the dad struggling, played by Patrick Wilson, who also directs this movie. So I thought that was super cool. But I do like Patrick Wilson. I know he's in The Conjuring 2. And then he was also in Phantom of the Opera. If you saw Phantom of the Opera, the Gerard Butler one, he played Raoul. So that was pretty cool. And of course, he's in Aquaman. He plays Orm, aka Ocean Master. So it was cool to see him come back to this horror franchise, because this one and Conjuring are pretty much his two big horror franchises. And ironically, I think they're both by James Wan. I think James Wan directed the first two Insidiouses, at least. But anyway, like, the family's pretty much fallen apart. They did get a divorce, and he's not really on great talking terms with his family. But one scene that I really liked from this movie that kind of just, it wasn't like in your face scary, it was kind of more like shivers down your spine, is when he was inside the car after the funeral. It was his mother that died, and he was just texting his son. And if you look in the back, you can see a figure slowly getting closer. And then by the time it should be right up at the window, because you can see it in the rearview mirror, the figure disappeared. So I thought that was really cool and really just like chilling looking at it. I'm like, oh, that's creepy, that's weird. But I really did enjoy it. The creature design, I guess, was fine for what it was. It wasn't anything big. It was just pretty much Darth Maul brought back again. And then they did the song again, the tiptoe through the garden, like that one. So that was fine. That was fun. The final battle, I guess you could call it, was pretty good. And it got to the point where the dad was gonna sacrifice himself and be like, all right, this is something I have to do. I want to do this for you guys. And spoiler alert for another horror film that came out this year, it kind of gave me the vibes of the end of Night Swim, because the dad ends up sacrificing himself in that movie as well. But overall, it wasn't a bad film. I'm glad that at the very end we found out, even though he was willing to sacrifice himself, he didn't have to. So that was actually a nice little twist on the ending, and he was still like a good guy. And he ended up rekindling things with his family a little bit more. And then we see the old lady from the other films. She was the main focus of part 4, because that was secretly a prequel. Well, I don't know if it was secretly, but at least for me, it was a prequel to the first one. And then she was just pretty much, you could tell it was her ghost, because by this point in the story, she probably would have died of old age. And she was pretty much just like, don't worry, You're making a great dad. And I was like, oh, that's actually really nice. But on a horror scale, I wouldn't say this is super scary, but as a film alone, I thought it was actually very well done. I really did enjoy it. It had a few pulling at your heartstrings moments. And as a conclusion to this franchise, the first one, in my opinion, is still the scariest film out of the entire franchise. But this one is a very well done film that kind of caps off the franchise. And if you go into it not thinking that it's going to be super horror filled, then I feel like you really enjoy this movie, because it was much, much better than what I was expecting out of it. And after that, I would say I would probably give it like a, I'd give it a 7.5. I really did enjoy it. It's a bit harder for horror movies to kind of get anything higher for me, because I love horror, but it's not my main go-to stuff. My main go-to genre is action, but this is still a very well-done movie that even pulled at your heartstrings a little bit. And if you only decide to watch Insidious 1, 2, and then this one, I feel like you'd be perfectly fine. But anyway, let me know what you thought of The Red Door down in the comments below. And that was my review of Insidious: The Red Door. So if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and a subscribe so I know to keep making more of these. If you have any video requests, please leave them down in the comments below. I'll do my best to reply, as I have a few video requests and those are being made. But if you do have any others, just let me know. As long as within my capability of making it, I will be making it. And if you saw Insidious: The Red Door, let me know what you thought of it down in the comments below. Did you like it? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Did you think it was just okay? And also, how did you think it was to a ending of the franchise? Because I feel like down the line, we'll probably get more Insidious films, but this might be the last one with this. The core family from the first two and then this one. And I gotta say, I thought it was a nice, like, just full circle moment for the franchise. But anyway, thanks for watching as always, and I'll see all of you in the next video. Bye!